Hey guys, Adam with Equipped Indoor. So this is going to be a quick tabletop overview of a new product that I just got. And this has been out for a while and in the bag. You know, what's in the bag, Adam? What's in the bag? It's a BioLite. So I just want to surprise you with that, guys. So we were actually talking about this on the podcast, and BioLite contacted us and sent us one to do a test review and a giveaway. So we'll be having this guy here to give away here soon enough. That's a retail price of approximately $130. So what is a BioLite? A BioLite is a powered camp stove that also produces enough electricity to charge your wireless devices. Now this has been used, a larger version been used in third world countries. That's how they got started to have a clean cooking area where people can cook with biomass, you know, trees and cardboard or whatever. It will produce less smoke so they can be used indoors with, you know, proper ventilation, of course. Also, you know, have some power source. So it's pretty cool. It did very well overseas. Let's go ahead and pull this out. This is how you can pack it. Now, as you guys can see, you know, it's pretty large, about the size of, a little bit bigger than the Nalgene bottle. Just to give you guys a point of reference. Here's a pen, you know, so it's got some mass to it. It's definitely not the most compact thing out there, but for a stove that can do what it can do, it's relatively compact. So we're gonna open it up and I'll show you the extra pieces that we have here. So there's the stove itself. We have the battery pack and everything that goes in there. We got some directions and some stuff I left in the bag. And it comes with some cardboard fire starting material sticks. And we have this little cable, USB cable, that it came with, and this is for pots to balance on there, or maybe smaller pots, I should say. Yeah, smaller pots. So, very simple construction. We're just going to take this end, put it in here. As you can see, this is one of the feet. This locks that piece into place, and then we have two other feet that we push out, and we're ready to go. There it is. Now, this does have a fan in here, which will circulate and, you know, the air in there to help this thing burn a little bit more effectively and efficiently. At the same time, you'll be able to plug your USB device in here and power it up. Now, there's all kind of ratios between how long you can power things up and how hot it has to be or how long it has to run. I do want to show you this. This kind of clicks on right here. Let me go do it that way. Hold on a second. There we go. There's a specific way to do this. I'm probably doing it wrong. There we go. And that's to balance smaller pots. So, pretty simple. So, pretty interesting concept. Now, we haven't burnt anything in this yet, as you guys can see. This is brand new. And this will turn on, though. You guys can hear the fan right now. It's a good draw of air in there. I think you just hold it in to turn it off. Yep. So, very simple. I'm going to pack it back up real quick and just give you guys a quick overview of this before we take it outside. Because I know you guys want to see me light a fire in this thing. So pretty compact. I don't know how sooty this gets. It's one concern off the get-go, because you're going to be placing this inside here. And of course, you're going to make sure you let this thing cool down before you start packing it up to roll out of camp. So, but solid construction, has a little bit of weight to it. Not that huge of an issue. I think this is definitely off the jump. This would be something that'd be very cool for car camping, to have that and be able to charge your devices if you're, you know, camping at a campground or something like that. For the ultralighters, it's a lot of weight for something that's ultralight. But you know, I'd wonder how much I could, like, you know, charge cameras, charge phones. That would probably help me out in the field a lot. They're saying about 4.5 minutes to boil 1 liter of water, which is pretty good. The fuel, burnt sticks, pine cones, pellets, any other biomass, pretty awesome. The height is about 8.25 inches. The width is about 5 inches. It weighs about 2 pounds, 1 ounce, or 935 grams. Pot weight limit on top of it is about 8 pounds or 1 gallon of liquid. So it does have a limit of how much weight we want to put on that. Stainless steel, aluminum, plastic construction. So pretty cool. I mean, you know, 3.4 kilowatts on low, 5.5 kilowatts on high. The USB power output max continuous is about 2 watts at 5 volts, peak 4 watts at 5 volts. Most USB chargeable devices, including smartphones, will work with this. So pretty cool. You know, we're gonna take it out here in a little bit. Just want to give you guys a quick overview of it new in the package before we go out there and get her dirty. So stay tuned, guys. We'll be right back. All right, guys, we're back. Got my BioLite stove out here, and actually, you guys didn't get to see it. I have some photographs here. Robert Oliver was here this weekend. We took this out and we burnt it. Had some mixed reviews about it. Again, the concept of it's very cool. One of my big issues with it is the size. It's just very large. But I know this is gonna sound crazy. I think a bigger version, the one they use in the third world countries, is probably a little bit more practical for survival or bug out situation where you can actually take your camp stove with you. I think it's probably working great out there doing humanitarian type things that it was originally designed for. When you get into this compact size, I believe the niftiness of it, it's kind of trendy, it's cool. I can see in a car camping scenario or someplace where you're out and you want to constantly change your, charge your batteries for your cell phones or other small devices, it might be nifty. But I really can't see anything past that. And there's so many other power options out there with solar power and battery power packs nowadays that I don't know if this is necessary. And there's another issue that I have with stoves like this where you actually have to constantly dump material in here. I'm going to show you guys right now. So in the bag where it came with these little, compressed cardboard type little fire starters. We're going to pull off two of these and a USB cable. So I did have a little bit of difficulty at first lighting it with this natural materials, because down in there you're not really getting much oxygen until you charge this up and you can turn the fan on high. At that point, flames shoot out of this thing like nobody's business. So I'm going to do a little test here. I got some water. I'm going to grab, this is my kit for another video, and this was actually part of this kit. Now that we got this done, I might not take this as part of this kit, and if I get this done this video quick enough, I might even go on a little trek. But I'm going to grab my pot in here. All right, got my pot. Go ahead and empty it of its other wares. And that way we can boil some water on here. Now I just have some sticks and everything. The big issue I had with this is I kept on having to take this off of the stove to throw more fuel in there. Now this thing burns through fuel. We were actually burning some pretty thick pieces of hickory in here. So this is gonna burn the smaller stuff a lot faster, but I kinda wanna give you guys a point of reference. What we wanna do here is, as soon as you light this match, there we go. Start adding some stuff in here. And we're gonna turn the fan on. Now there's two settings, high and low. Of course, you need to have a little bit of residual heat or a charge on there to get it to go to high out the gate. And I was kind of fearful for overstuffing this. Kind of like I just did. I overstuffed it and put the fire out. Oh, yeah, still got a little flame left. There we go. All right, I'm gonna take some fat wood. Doesn't take much with the fat wood. I'm gonna turn the fan up. All right, so this thing already had a charge on it, as you can see. So turning the fan up. Let me give you guys some closer shots. Let's see, it went out. So we weren't getting enough power out of it.
So obviously the wood I got in here is a little too green. That's dry. That's too green. Too green. This feels dry. Yeah, it's good. Now, one thing that's really cool about this, this is pretty safe to the touch. Just around here, it gets a little bit warm, but it's not that bad. I mean, you really gotta get in there and touch that. But the outside is, you know, we tested that out. That was great. So we still haven't reached the gasification yet. And you get to see those jets really produce some flames. And like I said before, we were chopping up pieces of hickory, a little bit thicker. So this is just, you know, debris that you would find. There we go, a little bit there. All right. Starting to see a little bit come out of those jets. All right, there we go. So you guys can see now, we got the, I can hear it. I can hear the air moving through the jets. We're getting much larger flames. At this point though, it starts to burn down really quickly. I put a larger piece in there so you guys can see it. You see it straightening out and folding. That's in real time, so that is pretty hot. All right, so let's go in here. I'm just gonna measure about a cup of water, a little bit more, probably a cup and a half of water. Now this does have a small little triangle piece that fits on here you guys saw earlier for smaller diameter pots. This thing just fits it. See how long we get it till we start boiling. Keep processing this wood while I wait. Now you can hear if we're getting some gasification in the chamber there. I can still hear it, but so you have to pay attention. This one thing, that this isn't a set it and forget it type of stove. Similar to like the issues I had with the solo stove. The solo stove though had one thing that this thing didn't have, had a smaller chamber. I really like things like the Emberlit where you can put the wood in from the side and just keep on pushing it along there. I think it's just, when it comes down to it, it's just a better design, you know. But of course, how do you do that with this kind of function? So maybe some kind of chute that you can set some larger wood in that would be a little bit more self-feeding. But I'm not the engineer, so. All right, so now I can hear that the jets have stopped. We're getting some steam, some bubbles. So the problem here is I've got to slowly move this, but throw more wood in there to get it back up to temperature. There's just not that much room to, ooh, that's hot. There's not that much room to slide that material in there. Now you guys can see these flames are coming out, shooting out now. So we're back up Now this is going to burn a lot hotter than some of your other stoves. So that is one positive attribute. You might be able to boil stuff pretty quickly. Now this is almost there. So we're about the 3 minute mark right now. We're just getting there. You guys can see I'll leave the top off. Well, if I leave the top off, it's gonna take longer. There we go. Got a raging boil right now. So we're gonna let that boil for a few minutes. Remember guys, I hear a lot of people giving misinformation in regards to all you need to do is bring your water to a boil and that's it. That is not true. There are some waterborne pathogens that you have to have the rolling boil. Some of these things can have oils and other things surrounding them, protecting them, that are going to absorb a lot of the energy. So you need to be able to break that down. So just, I tell you guys, you know, they say 5 minutes of boiling is good. Sometimes I do 10 minutes. You know, what a waste of water that is. You know, I'd rather be safe than sorry. So I'm having some issues keeping it up. Now it's just back to a gentle boil. So as you guys can see, and we're only 6 minutes in this thing even being introduced to heat. So it's going by pretty fast. And now you can kind of balance it up here to not lose as much heat and throw some stuff in here. There we go. So some larger pieces of wood would probably be better at this point. Well, there's a good indicator. There we got that raging boil again. So I got it to boil pretty fast. That did pretty well. Now if we're cooking long term over something or low heat, that'd probably be a little bit better as well. All right, so we'll be right back, guys. We're gonna grab something else. All right, gang, so let's see if we can cook on it. All right, so at this point, all we got is embers. So we'll throw some more small pieces in there. Throw some bigger pieces in there now. This is the kind of stuff we were working with before. All right, guys, so we're gonna go ahead and see if we can cook on this. I know it's a non-stick pan, but I still need that bacon fat flavor. There's a little topsy-turvy. Yeah, I was feeling kind of lazy, guys. I didn't want to get the cast iron out. Now, this is supposed to be a biomass stove. So let's test that theory out. Why not, right? After all, this is equipped to endure. still cool to the touch. Well, that cools down. Throw some bigger pieces in here now. Just see how well they do. It's that Andy Roy Fiddleback Forge Sneaky Pete of mine. All right, so that'll be a good test while I eat my eggs. I love this knife. Very tasty. So looking at the way the larger fuel wood is burning, you guys probably can't see, but it's tearing it down pretty quick. So I almost think burning some larger stuff like this and raising the bed of coals may have solved a lot of my consistency problem. I don't know how hot that would make it, but as you guys can see right now, that thing is rocking and rolling. So you guys can see, it's charring that stuff pretty well. All right, let's do this, guys. This water's still a little warm. So this is about half full. Let's see how well that does for the old boiling. Give you guys a point of reference. We've been burning this for about 40 minutes now, depending on how much is edited. See, I don't have any gasification right now. That's kind of a disappointment. So the convection is not as efficient as the conduction here. As you guys can see, I mean, I threw some pretty big pieces in there. They're not doing much of anything. Yeah, see, even with all those coals in there right there, I'm not getting much heat out of that. Should be stirring a fire with a piece of fat lighter. So you gotta find that proper ratio between some good coal fuel wood, build up the layers, and keep on putting in some different material. I mean, this water's hot. I mean, it's like wash hot. It's nowhere near boiling. It doesn't take much to get it started, I'll tell you that much. I see the flame's already gone. When in doubt, throw some fat lighter in there. Once you can get it lit, it does produce a good amount of heat. It's overcomplicated, I guess, the thresholds of sizes of wood you need to be consistent. Again, I think this platform would be better suited for something substantially larger. Well, if nothing else, the water is pasteurized, but I'm kind of disappointed how some of this harder wood isn't getting me the results that I want. Now, everything is burning down to ash in here, so it's definitely producing some heat down there, but I'm just not seeing what I want to see in regards to transferring that energy up here. Don't know where I'm quite going wrong. I thought I had this thing figured out for a second there. again, I feel like I gotta go to this really small kindling size material to get the results that I want. You guys wanna see something cool? See that flame if I lift it up a little bit? As you guys can see, it does get so hot. Now we're at a raging boil. So I just had to get it there. It raised the temperature slowly. As soon as we hit that threshold, we were good. But it's that right mix of the size fuels. Now you guys can see, you can see the vortex in there. All right, guys, I'm gonna let this burn down for you. So just keep on watching. And we'll be right back with our some final thoughts for this test.